Good morning, everyone. It's Elaine here. Today, we're going to do a couple of classical mat exercises that will target your six-pack zone. So roll out your mat and join me. The first one is called the double leg stretch. Roll down the mat, lie on your back, and center yourself on the mat. Hug your knees in towards your chest and place your hands on either side of the shin. Keep your heels together, toes apart in a V shape. Then, curl your head and shoulders up to the tips of the shoulder blades. Inhale to extend both legs vertically and arms up to a high diagonal. Then exhale to move your arms in a big circle around and back to serving position. Hugging your knees into your chest. Inhale to reach, exhale to pull. This exercise is a wonderful way to build core strength while improving the stability and coordination. Make sure to pull your tailbone down to a support to keep your spine lengthened. The commonistic for this exercise would be your head flinging back as you reach your arms up and overhead. This will cause a lot of neck strain. To rectify, keep your eyes on your abs and tuck your chin in towards your chest as if you are cradling a mini tangerine between your chin and your chest, and repeat the same movement. Then for level 2, we'll extend both arms and legs out to a higher diagonal and pulling it all back in, drawing your knees into your chest. Level 2 is challenging, more challenging as there will be a heavier load on your spine as you extend both legs and arms out. Pull your navel to your spine to keep your back from overarching and maintain eyes on abs the whole time. And keep your heels squeezed together to activate your inner thighs and hug your midline. Remember to anchor your hips firmly onto the mat for support and stability. We have another 4, 3, 2, and we'll hold it up. And for another 4, pull your navel to your spine. 3, pull your ribcage in. 2, and hug your knees in towards your chest and lower your head down and rock from side to side. Then we'll roll up to seat for the second exercise. It's called the saw. Open your legs slightly wider than mat width apart with the back of your heels on the floor. And keep your feet flat through your heels and extend your arms out to the side. Palms facing down. Engage your abs to lift your spine tall. Twist your torso to the right, round forward, reaching for your right pinky toes with your left pinky finger. Then return tall to center and twist to the opposite side, bringing your opposite arms down and behind your body. Then back to center. This is an excellent way to strengthen the rotator cuff of your spine or stretching your hamstrings, upper back, and your chest. Common mistake for this exercise would be your opposite hip hiking up as you reach for your pinky toes, like what you can see right here. To rectify, press your pelvis down onto the floor the whole time. And make sure that your kneecaps are facing the ceiling throughout the whole movement. Then for level 2, extend both legs out and press the back of your heels down onto the floor, flexing through your heels. And we'll repeat the same movement. Level 2 is more challenging as you have to squeeze your obliques tighter to deepen your rotation and dive deeper for your pinky toes. Common mistake for this exercise for level 2 would be your upper body collapsing down towards your thigh. This will take the focus out of your core. To rectify, pull your navel to your spine as you curl forward, as if you're rounding over a giant beach ball. keeping some space between your hips and your ribs. And as you continue, make sure to press your legs long down into the mat for support and stability. And draw your shoulders down and away from your ears. We have another 5 more to go. 4, rolling up through your spine, lengthening through the crown of your head. 3, 2, and 1 last one. And we come up, sitting up tall, and close your legs. The final exercise will be the side lying double leg lift and lower. So lie on your right side with your head supported by your extended bottom arm. And make sure to keep your body in one straight line aligned with the back edge of the mat. Keep your hips stacked by bringing it forward and pushing it down, lifting your bottom weight slightly off the mat. Then place your top hand in front of the mat and press it down for support. Then from here, engage your abs, squeeze your heels together, and lift both legs off the mat, hover it, then lower back down. Lift, then resist the gravity on the way back down. This is a surefire way to blast your obliques, hips, inner and outer thighs, and glutes. Commonistic for this exercise would be your hips swaying back and forth as you lift and lower your legs. To rectify, engage your obliques tightly and press your bottom hip down onto the mat the entire time for support. Exhale each time you lift both legs up and inhale to lower it back down. Remember to keep your hips and shoulders squared, and then for level 2 we add scissor motion. Lift both legs off the mat and hover them, then simultaneously extend your bottom leg forward, top leg back, and you switch. Imagine your legs are like the blades of the scissors as you continue the side kick motion. Level 2 is way more challenging and requires more core strength and postural support. Remember to keep your head in line with your spine and chest wide open. And really pull your navel to your spine to keep your body from swaying back and forth. You should feel a lot in your inner thighs and your obliques muscles. Remember to keep some space for the cookie in your bottom waist. We have another 5 more to go. 4, 3, 2, and we'll hold it right there for another 4. Stay with me. 3, breathe through the burn. 2, and close your legs and lower it back down. And we'll switch sides. This time we'll lie on our left side. And support your head with the extended bottom arm. And keep your body in one straight line and align it with the back edge of the mat. Keep your hips stacked by bringing it forward and stack it down, lifting your bottom waist slightly off the mat. And place your top hand towards the front of the mat and press it down firmly. From here, engage your obliques and squeeze your legs together to lift both legs off the mat, then lower them down with control and strength. This is one of my favorite exercises as it helps to create long lean muscle tone in your legs
while challenging your balance. The top leg acts as a resistance as you lift your bottom leg off the mat, and the sheer weight of your legs will surprise you. Remember to keep your shoulders and hips stacked as you continue. Then for level 2, we add scissor motion, lift both legs off the mat and hover them, and simultaneously extend your bottom leg forward, top leg back, then we'll switch sides. As you continue with the side kick motion, remember to keep your hips stacked. And this is way more challenging as you are balancing on your hips the entire time. Remember to keep your rib cage pulled in and squeeze your obliques to lift the bottom waist slightly off the mat. We have another 5 more to go. 4, press your bottom hip firmly down onto the mat. 3, 2, and we hold it at the top and really squeeze your inner thighs and oblique muscles for 4, 3, 2, and close your legs together and lower them down and come back right up. And we're done for today. Thank you for joining me. See you next time.